yesterday we kind of introduced them and we talked about Asteroidea. Today we're going to look at some more specific groups. Today we're going to look at Ophiuridia, which are the basket stars and the brittle stars. And these are actually the most diverse of all the echinoderms, so there's a lot of different kinds of these. They're typically going to be predators, scavengers, filter feeders, so they eat a variety of foods. And they have very, very long arms that can branch, so that instead of just having like one single arm like you see in the regular sea star, they could have branches that are coming off of them. Basket stars are a good example of that. It forms kind of a basket-like shape when they have a lot of branching on them. If the arms remain singular, that's what a brittle star would look like. But their arms are so long and thin that they look like they're going to break, which is why they're called brittle stars. Brittle stars can break off an arm if a predator attacks and regenerate it later. So they are the ones that are more able to do this. This is called autonomy, which is the ability to break off a structure and then regrow it for defensive purposes. So this is what we're going to see in lizards as well, specifically geckos. Geckos are going to experience this where they break off their tail and they can regrow their tail. Also dioecious, which again means that the males and females are separate.
Individually, which is kind of cool. They're placed in like these little sockets, and so when you
Their spines are hollow like a needle, and they often will contain dangerous venom that can be very toxic to animals and to people. And honestly, I don't remember if they're toxic to kill. I think it does. Definitely makes you very sick. which day, because a lot of it will depend on if we're here tomorrow, if tomorrow is Monday or not. So, questions?
I don't know.
No? Tomorrow, I think the high is 15.